Hi friends, in the last class we have covered the concept of redemption of preferences. I think I might have practiced well. We had a detailed discussion on that, and today's class is about bonus shares and right issue. It's a very small topic. Even the small topic is the opportunity to score marks, bonus shares. We had discussion on bonus shares in investment accounting. Am I right? You know, here bonus shares, they are given. Bonus issue means a issue of free additional shares to existing shareholders is called as bonus shares. Generally, when a company goes for issue of bonus shares, if company has built up substantial reserves, they don't know what to do. A company has built up substantial reserves. I'm talking about, it can be free reserves, it can be capital redemption reserve. Okay, in the company, they don't know what is to be done with the reserves which they are having, substantial reserves, their company can go for issue of bonus shares. So, the word bonus, appears to be free, you know. Do you feel that, is it free? Do you feel that bonus shares are free? Company is issuing bonus shares. And company is issuing bonus shares from where they are giving? From the reserves. The company may issue fully paid bonus shares to shareholders. It's free reserves, security premium account, capital redemption reserve account. Think of it. Okay. I'll answer that first. Generally, all successful companies, while we discuss about bonus, the meaning of bonus later on, all successful companies increase their capital base by giving free shares to existing shareholders from the reserves which cannot be distributed as dividends. From the reserves which cannot be distributed as a dividend. Now, in this case, what are the reserves which cannot be distributed as dividend? Security premium cannot be distributed as dividend. I told you already, security premium is a capital reserve. Then you may ask a question. Sir, capital reserve, we talked about capital reserve. We talked about capital reserve, created of capital profit. Then directly you can use the word capital reserve instead of security premium. But security premium is being governed by Section 52 of Companies Act 2013. The security premium can be used by as per legal provisions of Section 52. So, you are having some special future to this, that is the security premium, even though it's a capitalism, but still we are using the word by calling it by name called as security premium. As I told you, all successful companies increase their capital base by giving free shares to its existing shareholders from the reserves which cannot be distributed as dividend due to either by law or financial prudence. I told you, security premium, as per law, you cannot issue. CRR, you cannot issue. Now, if that is the case, then what is the purpose? Then you can do one thing. security premium, CRR, they all comes under the category of shareholders' funds only. But these two can't be used as for declaring the dividend. You cannot distribute these two as dividend. But there is one option. You can go for capitalization of this. In simple words, capitalization of profits. It's a revenue or a capital nature. In the process of converting profits or reserves into paid up capital. It's a paid up capital. But one thing you should remember, issue of bonus shares is not a source of fund. Like whenever you issue shares, it's a source, you know, source application. Source is a liability. You get, whenever you issue shares, you get a source. You collect some money. But bonus shares, free shares, it's not a source of funds. That means a bonus share is a free share issued without any consideration to an existing shareholder in the ratio of number of shares held by the shareholder. Then the logic you can see, issue of bonus shares decrease the reserves and surplus but increase the issued capital. But it does not bring any change in cash flow or net worth of the company. In simple words, it doesn't allow you to raise cash. There is no cash inflow. So it is not affecting the balance sheet. Simple words, we can say bonus shares will increase issue capital and it will decrease reserves and surplus. Sir, these two we got it, sir. These two can't be issued as dividend. But free reserves can be given as dividend. But these free reserves also you can use when you got substantial reserves. You want to go for increase of the capital base. You don't want to give this money to the shareholders. So then the free reserves also can be capitalized. But I think these two first preference will be given to a security premium or CRR. First preference you can give to CRR. Then you can give preference to security premium for capitalization. Still, if you want, lastly you can go for free reserves. But I think that is a rational move. Now, I told you what is the meaning of free. Nobody will do anything. Nobody will give you anything with free. Simple logic, my dear friends. Free, I think for me, free is not the right word to be used. According to me. Are my money, mera money, mere ko de rahe, usme kya free hai usme? Bolo yaar. It's my money. My money means the shareholders reserves. Because in the latest format, once upon a time we used to have share capital reserves and surplus. Heading now, Schedule 3, latest format, you are calling it a shareholders funds. It's a revenue reserve or capital reserve, anything. It is related to whom? Shareholders fund. But these two things, that is security premium CRR, can't be used for issue of dividend. So, they were able to find out a way. Okay, we do one thing, we capitalize the capitalized portion of free reserves or already capitalized portion of CRR. CRR, from where you get CRR? You learn previous chapter. Capitalizing divisible profits. Now, this CRR, as I told you in the last class, is a promotion that it will increase your share capital. So, security premium and CRR, these two all has been converted into bonus shares. Free reserves, if you want, you can capitalize it. Then the capitalized portion is converted into bonus shares. So, in simple words, instead of giving you money, they are increasing the capital base. That's it. They are increasing the capital base. It leads to dilution. That's it. But the company is not going to get anything. But good news is that company is having enough reserves and they are giving the bonus shares. So bonus is a free reserves we talked about. Free issue of free. Free means, simple words, the company is not getting any money. That is the meaning of free. Means issue of free additional shares. That means generally that we should look in this context of it. Okay. Here, free additional shares means no source of funds. Company is not collecting any money. It's a no source of funds. Why? Because they are giving shares but not getting funds. That is what? Free. Because you are giving the shares, in turn you are not getting it. That's it. That is the meaning. But actually, it doesn't amount to free shares. It appears to be free from company's point of view. The shareholder's point of view, instead of giving, if you are a shareholder, if I am a shareholder, I am already capitalized a portion of reserves is being converted into shares. Or excess reserves, but they don't know what to do. And those reserves are converted into capitalized part and they are giving you fresh shares. But they are giving you additional shares. Sorry. They are giving you additional shares. So here, if you look at it, is there any fee? No. Our money is being given in the form of shares. It's only logic for discussion. But one more point has been given. Bonus share should not be issued out of revaluation reserves. That is, reserves created by revaluation of assets. Like you said, you will be having some revaluation of assets. There is a upward revaluation. Appreciation of the value of assets. I think that will not be considered for bonus shares. It is only apprehension, you know, that my value of asset has been upwarded, increased. Okay. So come on, tell me, a company may issue fully paid bonus shares to shareholders out of its free reserves. Point number two, security premium account. Point number three, capital redemption reserve. This right issue also we discussed, but we work out the problems in the next class. About the right issue, if you say, right issue is an issue of rights to a company's existing shareholders. You know, we have learned this. Right shares are shares which are offered to existing shareholders at a concessional rate when compared to market value, a discount price. Right share is an issue of rights to a company's existing shareholder that entitles them to buy additional shares directly from the company in proportion to their existing holdings within a fixed time period. Simple words, instead of going for public issue, company needs additional capital. Instead of going for public issue, waste of time, company may offer the shares to existing shareholders if they offer to purchase. That's it. Issue of right shares. If rights offering the subscription price at which each share may be purchased generally at a discount to the current market price. Rights are often transferable. We have seen a bit of it in investment account. Allowing the holder to sell them in open market. The difference between the come right and the X right value of the share is the value of the right. We discuss about what is come right and X right when problems comes. The difference between come right and X right is the value of the right. How to calculate come right is a short question. We'll see later on. Okay. So right shares also theory part we have completed. Now, generally we say bonus issue means, as I told you, okay, and this is completely, you know, next coming back to this. as per section 63 subsection 2 of the Companies Act, bonus shares cannot be issued unless partly paid shares are made fully paid. This is very important. Bonus shares cannot be issued unless partly paid shares are made fully paid, like 8 rupees has been called. Unless you convert that into 10 rupees, you cannot issue fully paid bonus shares. Para 13(2) of the table F under Schedule 1 to the Companies Act 13 allows use of free reserves for paying up amounts unpaid of shares held by existing shareholders. This is important. Allows use of free reserves for paying up amounts unpaid on shares existing. For paying amount unpaid, that means 2 rupees is unpaid out of 10 rupees. This 2 rupees will become unpaid and you can use free reserves for conversion of partly paid shares into fully paid shares. You have seen the first point. A company can issue free shares to existing shareholders. Issue fully paid up bonus shares. Here this is important. Fully paid up bonus shares from free reserves, security premium, CR. Okay. I think the bracket is to tell you, I've given you. Okay, these three fully paid shares. And then coming back to partly paid shares. Unpaid shares, partly paid, unpaid shares. Suppose 8 rupees has been paid, 2 rupees unpaid. They can use only which reserves, my dear friends? Free reserves can be used. Is this clear? They can use free reserves. On a combined reading of both provisions, it can be said that free reserves may be used for paying up amount of unpaid on shares held by existing shareholders. And a combined reading of both the provisions, it can be said that free reserves may be used for paying up amount of unpaid on shares held by existing shareholders. I take an example of say rupees 2 is unpaid. If 2 is unpaid, I'm taking the example. Is this clear? Okay. Now, those equity premium account and capital instruments cannot be used. This is important. We cannot use security premium account and capital redemption reserve account for converting the partly paid shares into fully paid shares. I think if you look at it, this is for, and this is for fully paid. Partly paid unpaid capital, which we have to use only free reserve only, which we cannot use security, we cannot use CRR, we cannot use. Is this clear? Right. Okay, my dear friends, are you following, all of you? So come on, today we have learned basic thing, the meaning of bonus shares we have learned, meaning of right shares we have learned. Okay, then we have learned what is bonus shares we have learned. A company can issue fully paid bonus shares or partly paid bonus shares. For fully paid bonus shares, a company can use free reserves, security premium, okay, fully paid up bonus shares, they can use 3. For partly paid shares, they can use only 3 reserves. That's it. Right? She has also meaning we have learned. Now coming back to this. Entry spot. Upon the sanction of initial bonus shares, entry is, as I told you, first you use CRR, then security premium account. Now, there is explanation of security premium account. There are two things. SEBI regulations are applicable for listed companies, please remember. Company Act is applicable for unlisted company. For listed companies, SEBI regulations can be used. When we are talking about security premium, as per SEBI guidelines, security premium to use security premium for issue of bonus shares, that security premium should be realized in cash. Like when company goes for issue of shares for cash, if company is issuing shares at premium, the premium also will be realized in cash. So that security premium can be used. But where issue of shares for consideration other than cash, when company has gone for issue of shares at premium, you know that issue of shares for cash, issue of shares for consideration other than cash, issue of shares for cash, issue of shares for cash, yes, security premium can be used for issue of bonus shares as per SEBI guidelines. But when you are issuing shares for consideration other than cash, you are not realizing security premium in cash. Say for example, 1 crore worth of building has been purchased, or 1 crore worth of plant and machinery has purchased by company. That 1 crore worth of purchase consideration settled by issue of shares at premium. Now that issue of shares is for consideration rather than cash. That means you are not going to realize that amount in cash. So if that is the case, security premium is not realized in cash. For listed companies, you cannot use security premium account. But for unlisted company, there is no restriction as per companies act. They can use security premium even if it is not realized in cash. So when you are reading the problem, you should be careful. Generally, if nothing is mentioned, we shall assume it is a listed company. Okay? If you got any doubt, you write a note. Assume it as a listed company. If specifically they are giving as unlisted company, security premium, even if it is not received in cash, I think unlisted companies can use security premium. But listed companies, they cannot use security premium if it is not realized in cash. I think this has been given here. You can see, my dear friends. Upon the sanction of an issue of bonus shares, debit capital redemption, debit security premium account, let me complete the entry. Debit general ledger, debit P&L account. These two are free reserves. You know the meaning of free reserve? The free reserves are those reserves which are as per last or latest audited balance sheet. These two can be taken as free reserves, and you are creating to which account? Bonus to shareholders account. Okay. Now, as per SEBI regulations, such securities premium should be realized in cash. Whereas under Companies Act, there is no such requirement. In accordance section 52, security premium may arise on account of issue of shares other than by way of cash also. Thus, for unlisted company, security premium not realized in cash may be used for issue of bonus shares, whereas the same cannot be used in case of listed companies. Okay, I think I have explained you. You have also seen. Upon issue of bonus shares, bonus to shareholders account data to share capital account. Next. Upon the sanction of bonus by converting partly paid shares into fully paid. I told you, for conversion of partly paid shares into fully paid, we need to use only, I told you, free reserves, no? So these two are free reserves. I have already told you. We can use free reserves only for converting partly paid shares into fully paid shares, where we cannot do security premium, etc. On making the final call, so if there is any final call, share final call, like final call only we'll be getting it, no? Debit share final call to credit share capital. On adjustment of final call, debit bonus to shareholders account to credit share final call account. Okay, is this clear? So today we have seen two models. One is, this is issue of bonus shares. You see, fully paid bonus shares. Fully paid. This problem is, journal entry is issue of that is why you we are using CRRI security. Here, B part upon sanction of converting partly paid shares into fully paid shares. Okay. Now we can go to problems. Following items appear in the trial balance of Bharat Limited, a listed company, has on 31st March level. 40,000 equity shares of 10 each. CRR security been collected in cash, and that too they have given as listed company. We need to have amount collected in cash. General reserve. Surplus, that is trade balance in profit and loss account. Now we can see the company decided to issue equity shares, equity shareholders a bonus share at the rate of 1 share for every 4 shares held, and for this purpose it is decided that there should be minimum reduction in free reserves. That means minimum reduction means you can use CRR first, you can use security premium. If required, then you have to go for general reserve. So past necessary and late. So first let us calculate number of bonus shares issued. That is for every 4 shares, 1 bonus 1. Therefore, for 40,000 equity shares, how many shares? That is 40,000 by 4. How many bonus shares company is giving? 10,000 bonus shares a company is issuing. Is this clear to all of you? Company is issuing 10,000 bonus shares. I think you can guess the entry. You have seen the entries already. CRR, because what is CRR? First, we will be using CRR. We have learned that capital redemption reserve can be used for issue of bonus shares. 55,000. Then we need 1 lakh. No, how you got 1 lakh? Amount required 10,000 into 10 rupees. No, number of bonus shares. Amount is equal to, how we can say, value bonus issue is equal to 10,000 shares into 10 rupees coming to 1 lakh. I want 1 lakh. And 1 lakh first from where I am using 55,000, I am going to use 30,000, then how much I want? 55 plus 30, 85. I need 15,000 from where? General reserve, that is what has been given. CRR 55, security and balancing. So bonus to shareholder. Then entry is bonus to shareholders to equity share capital. Is this clear? Now let us see the second problem. Following the extract of balance sheet of Solid Limited as of 31st March 2011. Authorized capital 10,000 12% preference shares of 10 each, 1 lakh equity shares of 10 each, issued and subscribed 8,000 12% preference shares of 10 each, fully paid 80,000, 90,000 equity shares of 10 each, 8 paid up. I think I told you, we have learned in the beginning. Bonus shares can be issued unless partly paid up shares are made fully paid up. Don't confuse yourself. You can convert partly paid shares into fully paid by asking the shareholders to make the payment. Or you can convert by issue of bonus share. That is second point you learn. So I think you have to go as per the instruction of the problem. So What is unpaid 2 rupees? Uncalled unpaid 2 rupees. Then we are having general reserve, revaluation reserve, security premium collected in cash, P&L account. Is this clear? Then we are having 12% debentures. On 1st April 2011, the company has made a final call. I think they are going for collection of the uncalled amount on 90,000 equity shares. The call money was received on 28th April. Thereafter, the company decided to capitalize its reserve by way of bonus at the rate of 1 share for every 4 shares held. Show necessary general entries. They are asking show necessary general entries. Okay. They are asking show necessary general entries in the books of company and prepare extract of the balance sheet immediately after bonus issue, assuming the company has passed a necessary resolution at the general body meeting for increasing the authorized cap also. Because whenever you are going for bonus shares, you should see that after issue of bonus shares, that is within the limit of authorized capital. Or better, authorized capital is meant for collection of amount from the public through issue of shares. So I think nowadays what the problem they are doing is that whatever the bonus shares you are going to, the extent of bonus issue you are going for increase of share capital. Okay, other is share capital. So I think this entry is clear to you. Equity share final call to equity share capital, because 90,000 shares, 10 rupees has been collected, 8 rupees has been paid up. So how much is to be balance is to be paid up? 2 rupees. Okay, so equity share final call to equity share capital. Here we are writing 90,000 shares into 2 rupees, that is uncalled unpaid has been asked to be paid. Then bank account equity share capital, final call money on 90,000 equity shares received. Now you need to go for bonus shares. So whenever you are doing a problem, I told you to work out number of bonus shares. Number of bonus shares for every 4 1 bonus. So therefore, what is the existing equity shares? 90,000. Don't take other scrap, you should take issue 90,000. So 90,000 by 4. If you calculate, you are getting, that is 22,500 bonus shares. Bonus shares. Now you need to have value of bonus shares. What is value? You can see what is the face value of bonus share? 10 rupees. No? 10 rupees. So 22,500 into 10. 2,25,000 is the value. So I need 2,25,000. That is what is being given. I am using 2,25,000 from security premium. Collected cash 20. Then I got revaluation reserve. Revaluation reserve, I told you, will not be considered. No? Why? Because there is an increase in the value of asset appreciation for which you have created valuation reserve. You cannot use. Now you are having 2 reserves. General reserve, P&L account. Now we are using general reserve 1,16,000. Now P&L account balancing figure. So 20,000 is towards security premium. From security premium we have used. General reserve 1,60,000. P&L account is balancing figure. So, in the issue of 1 share for every 4 shares held by utilizing various reserves as per board resolution. Why we are not using revaluation reserve? I told you revaluation reserve is nothing but by creation, by increase in the value of asset. Appreciation the value of asset doesn't give you money. So I think that reserve will not be considered. Okay, then bonus shares to equity share capital. Now, the first important point is about share capital. I'd like to tell you. See, authorized equity share capital, it has been given in the problem actually. If you look at it, authorized share capital, 10 lakhs has been given. Is this clear? We are not talking about preference. 10 lakhs. So, what they have done, I think you can do two approaches have been followed. First approach is, they got 11 lakh 25. So, how they have done actually, it has been mentioned here. See, any X is the authorized cap limit given the problem. And already issued cap is how much? 9 lakh. So companies will go for issue of 1 lakh. 1 lakh issue. Now, what is the bonus share value? 2,25,000. Already excess authorized cap is how much? 1 lakh. So 225 minus 1 lakh, then we are getting a balance of how much? 1,25,000, because company should have authorized cap of 10 lakhs. So in simple words, 9 lakhs plus 2,25,000 become 11,25,000. In this way also you can understand. Already existing is how much? 10 lakhs. We can go for 1,25,000. Is this clear to all of you? You can either go by this 10 lakhs minus 9 lakh, 1 lakh is a surplus till you are having authorized. 225, you are going for bonus issue. You are using 1 lakh. How much till you need? 1,25,000. Or 9 lakhs is existing share capital paid up plus 225 becomes 725. Already existing is how much? 10 lakhs. So you need 1,25,000. You need 1,25,000. Limit to be increased in case of authorized capital. This is one option. The other option is, I think that will be simple instead of comparing. What they are doing actually is that existing share capital is 10 lakh, no? What is the value of bonus issue? 2,25,000. Then the authorized capital will become 12,25,000. Simple. Existing authorized capital, after issue, what are the bonus shares you are issuing? Don't look at whether sufficient or sufficient. 2,25,000 can be added. Is it clear or not? It is simple. Then authorized capital will become almost 12,25,000. But here they have taken almost 11,25,000. They have followed the difference. How you got this 11,25,000? I have told you, no? 9 lakhs plus after bonus issue 225. It has become 11,25,000. Existing is how much? You can do either way. Or directly 10 lakhs plus 2,25,000 becomes 12,25,000. Okay. And then you know, other different capital same. Issued sub fully paid share capital, welcome preference shares 80. You got here preference share capital, the problem. 80. Authorized 1 lakh, issued is 80. Okay. Then preference share capital 1 lakh, but issued is 80. This is authorized, this is issued. So therefore, total share capital is equal to, come on, tell me, issued 11,25 plus 80, it is coming to 12,05,000. Now, revaluation reserve, we are not using. Security room 20,000 has been used. General reserve 1,60,000 has been used for bonus issue. P&L account only 45,000 were used for bonus issue. This is extract. Okay, my dear friends. I hope you all are following this. Okay, next. We'll move on to the third question. before I explain that, here it is to be ensured that orders capital after bonus issue should not be less than the issued share capital including bonus issue. In all the practice problems, orders capital will either be increased by the amount of bonus issue or the value of additional shares. Bonus issue less unused orders capital, excess of other capital in comparison to the issued shares before bonus issue. You got two options. Orders capital may be either increased by the amount of bonus issue or the value of additional shares, bonus issue less unused orders capital. That is what we have done in this case. Bonus issue, unauthorized orders capital. Unauthorized capital is how much? 1 lakh. What is bonus issue? 225. Still, how much we need? 125. That is what. Or other capital will either be increased by the amount of bonus issue. This will be simple. 10 lakhs plus 2 lakh 25. It will become 12 lakhs 25,000. Okay. Now read the problem before I explain. Hold on a minute. Yes, you can see the illustration 3. Read the problem. So same problem 8 paid up, no? General reserve, CRR, security premium, collected cash, paid account. On 1st April, company has made final call of 2 rupees each. On 1,35,000 equity shares. It is same like only 2 rupees, 1,35,000. Here 1,15,000 means 15,000 still have not gone for issue. So necessary entries in the books of company. Equity share final call to equity share capital. 1,35,000 2. Bank to equity share final call. Now, we need to, whenever you are doing a problem, we need to go for bonus shares. One share for every four shares. Same problem. One share for every four means 1,35,000 by four, no? Simple words. 1,35,000 by four. How many bonus shares you are getting? 33,750 bonus shares. Here we can write. Number of bonus is equal to number of bonus shares is equal to 33,750. Value is equal to 33,750 into 1080. 3,33,750 is the value of bonus. 37,500 is the value. Okay. Now that from where we can use? We can use from first CRR, we can use from security premium, then we can use from general ledger. If still it is not sufficient, we can go for P&L account. That is what has been done. Security premium 37,500 we got. CRR 60. General ledger is how much you are having? 180 completely has been used. A P&L account, actually you are having a balance of 3 lakhs. How much you need? 60,000. I think this can be taken as a balancing figure. Okay, then the entry will be, these two entries I have already told you. This entry also I told you. Bonus to shareholders to equity share capital. Now extract. This is second option we went for here. The first option what we have done actually, first option what we have done, here we got see we got 15 lakhs, no? 15 lakhs means 13,50,000. 1,50,000. So what we can do, 3,37,500 minus 1,50,000. Then you can go for increase of authorized capital, 1,87,500. Or directly 15 lakhs you can add. I think that is easy, no? Directly 15 lakhs you can add which one? Issue of bonus. I think this option is a better for you to do without having any confusion. So two options has been given. Which is easy? Existing authorized capital, whenever issue, whether sufficient or insufficient, don't see. Simply add issue of bonus shares to equity share at a face value. Then what is authorized capital now? 18,37,500. But that is authorized capital. Okay. This has been given authorized capital. Now, equity share, existing equity shares is how much here? 1,35,000 equity shares. 1,35,000 equity shares. Plus 33,750. 1,35,000 plus 33,750 is coming to how much? 1,68,750. Is this clear how you got this? 1,35,000 plus 33,750. We are getting 1,68,750. Here you can write like consideration other than cash. But of above 33,750 equity shares, each were issued by way of bonus share. This is disclosure. Okay? And other is cap also has been taken. So, reserves and surplus, what is the balance? P&L account. Because P&L account, how much you have used? P&L account, you have used 60,000, no? So, 3 lakhs minus 60, it is coming to how much? 2,40,000. 3 lakhs minus 3 lakhs minus 60,000. 60,000 was used for issue of bonus shares. Okay, my dear friends, I think this is a very simple chapter. Last one I am explaining you. Whenever you are going for issue of bonus shares, you do one thing. Existing authorized capital, you add face value of bonus issue. Then that will become authorized capital. And issued, etc., you all are aware of it. So, today conclusion, we have learned. Bonus shares can be fully paid bonus shares, fully paid bonus shares. You can use free reserves, you can use CRR, you can use security premium for realizing cash. That is in case of listed company. Listed company are governed by SEBI guidelines. Then, for partly paid shares, company can issue fully paid. But we haven't seen any company can issue bonus shares. But we haven't had any problem. But we have discussed only free reserves can be used for issue of such bonus shares. Okay. But however, partly called, partly paid, company can again find, you can go for final call. They can collect, then only the company can go for issue of fully paid bonus shares. I think that we have seen the second problem and third problem. Okay. I hope this discussion is useful to you. With this, we have completed bonus shares. Maybe one or two things which I would like to tell you, having a combination of redemption of preferences and bonus shares. One problem I remember, that if possible, I'll take up that tomorrow, and then I can go for right shares. With that, we'll be finishing of this chapter. Then we can go for last two topics which I need to handle is that redemption of debentures followed by cash flow statements. Okay. Thank you very much. God bless you all.